Okay, hello friends and welcome to Micro Concepts. Today we are going to learn about Ames test, or also known as Ames test. This is a biological assay and it is used to test if a given substance is mutagenic or not. So basically, what is mutagen? A physical or chemical agent that changes the genetic material, which is nothing but the DNA. So the process which changes this genetic information of an organism is known as mutagenesis, okay, which is nothing but resulting in a mutation. Remember, not all mutagens are carcinogens, okay, not all mutagens are carcinogens. Now you all know that cancer is a genetic disease which is linked with mutations. So whether a drug which is under test is a mutagen or not, for that we are going to use this test. Okay, now let's see what are the organisms or what all we require for this test. The strain which is used for this test is Salmonella typhi murium, which is a histidine deficient mutated strain. What is histidine? Histidine is an amino acid which is used in biosynthesis of proteins. Okay, so what is a protein? It's nothing but a chain of amino acids which make up to a protein. Now the strain which we are using is histidine deficient, which is denoted as histidine negative strain. Okay, so organism is not able to produce histidine here, and when it is able to produce histidine, it is known as histidine sufficient strain, which is denoted as His plus, which is HIS HIF and noted with a plus symbol, which means it can produce histidine. Okay, so for this test we will use two sets, which are nothing but a control and a test. So we will require a media plate for Salmonella typhi murium, which is devoid of histidine, which means it has no histidine in it. Then we are going to add liver extract from mice. Then why to use this? In case of humans or animals, when it is a in vivo case inside our body, when we are administered with a drug or a chemical agent, if it is mutagenic, then the mutagenicity may increase in our liver. When this drug is processed in our liver, maybe at that time the mutagenicity may increase. Or for example, if it is not a mutagen before, then it can happen that when it is processed in liver, you can get the mutagenic effect when it is processed. Now let's see the test. So this is a control set and the other one is a test. So let's first see the control side. So here we are using a liver extract in the tube with Salmonella, which is histidine deficient. Okay, so in this test we are in this tube for control test we are using only these two things. So let it be there for 1 or 2 minutes, let it react, and then you plate it on a histidine lacking medium. Then you incubate for the given incubation condition and observe the results. So for control you will not get any growth. Why? Because organism is histidine deficient, means it will need histidine from a out source on a plate for its growth. But the media is already devoid of histidine, so it will not grow. Why? Because your Salmonella is already histidine deficient, so it is not able to produce its histidine on its own. Okay, so now let's see the test. For this, in a tube we are having test substance which is under test. So we will have a tube with test substance, liver extract and salmonella which is histidine deficient. Okay, let it react in the tube, and after some time we have to plate it as we did it in control. We will plate this on a histidine lacking media. Okay, so now here if the test material or the test substance is having any mutagenic potential, then we will get to see it in our results. So let's see, after incubating this plate, if you see some colonies on your plate, then you can say that, or you can conclude that your test substance is mutagenic. Okay, why you observe the growth here? It is due to the test substance which caused reverse mutation in organism, and now your organism is able to produce its own histidine. Okay, remember the salmonella which we are using in the test, it is histidine negative, which is histidine deficient. It cannot produce histidine, but now due to the test substance, it has own his property of producing its own histidine. So let's see what is a reverse mutation. Reverse mutation is nothing but the correction of mutation, or you can say if there is something wrong in your DNA information, it will get corrected. That is a reverse mutation. For in this case of histidine, the gene, histidine producing gene, has got its ability back for producing the functional protein. Okay, so on plate, if you get many aggregated colonies, if you get many aggregated colonies, this is the true result, that is positive test for reverse mutation. If you get two or three scattered colonies on plate on incubation after 48 hours, it may also known as a false positive test. This, in this case, you have to repeat the test. Okay, this false positive test is due to the spontaneous mutation which has occurred in some of the bacterial cells. This is not a true result. Okay, so you need to repeat your test again. Then I would like to focus on a point that if you get a blank plate after you testing your test substance, if you get a blank plate, it also means that your test substance is not mutagenic. Okay, so you will write in your report that the test substance is not mutagenic. Okay, so I had not drawn that diagram, but you can get these three results. In case of control, you will get a blank plate, and in case of a non-mutagenic substance in test, you can get a blank plate. And for test substance where it is a mutagen, it has a mutagenic property, there only you will get growth. And for this, if there are two or three colonies on your plate, it can be concluded as a spontaneous mutation. Okay. Thank you. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, share and comment. Thank you.